This is the time to talk about social media content calendar once again. So not a long time ago, I made a video about how to make a content calendar for social media in Excel. I did a full step-by-step tutorial how you could do that. If you want to watch this video, I am going to link it there or there and in the description down below. Today, I wanted to show you how to make a content calendar for social media in Trello. I am a Trello newbie and I am also really obsessed with Trello now that I know it. Shout out to Adeline. Thank you so much for telling me about Trello. What is Trello and what does it do? So Trello is a collaboration tool that organizes your projects into boards. So I organize my week, I organize my blog post content, my YouTube videos, and all of that on Trello. I organize everything about my work and everything about my day, to-do list and all of that. First, we will create an account together on Trello. Trello is free. There's tons of features you won't have, but if you are a solopreneur, a small business, or if you use Trello for your personal life, you can use the free version of Trello. I use the free version of Trello and I love it. I really don't need more. So step number one, we're going to create an account together. Then we will create our first board, our first card, and I will show you everything you are able to do on Trello to make this content calendar the best thing ever for your social media. Let's get into it. Okay guys, so here we are on Trello on my computer, and I wanted to show you quick what I do on Trello to organize my work and organize my life. There's so much more than I need to do because, as I told you, I just started to using this amazing tool. As you can see, you have some boards, and in each board you have cards. In those cards you can do checklists and describe your project. Today we are only going to focus on social media content calendar, but preview on what I'm doing on Trello. As you can see, there is my website. So when you click on it, there is everything that I'm working on, and I have my blog post ideas before publishing and a promotion, and there is my content calendar over here. I did July to December for the end of this year, and then there is what I have to write, what I need to export to my website, and what I need to schedule. And when everything is complete, a complete card inside each of those cards. So this is the board and this is the list, and inside those lists you have cards. For example, that is the things that I need to make for this week. So I described a little bit of what I need to do. And then I have a before publishing with a to-do list. I did the same for YouTube. That's a board. In my board I have lists, and each list I have cards, everything that I need to do. If they are completed, I can label them. So basically this is how I organize myself, and this is my content calendar for YouTube. I did one board for each social media. I haven't done one for Instagram and Pinterest, but I am about to. Mostly Pinterest, because there's pins that I need to create for my website, YouTube, etc. I also have a work week checklist. I'm using a planner to schedule my week and make to-do list. However, my work week checklist is all the things that I do repeatedly. Now I'm going to log out. We are going to do the entire process on how to sign up for an account on Trello, how to create your first board, and after we're going to build a social media content calendar for you guys on Trello. And it's super easy, it's fast, and let's do this together. Let's start by signing up, and we are going to use my old email. Obviously you have to put your full names and sign up. So here we are. Welcome to Trello. You can organize just about anything with a Trello board. Start by naming your board something related to the project you're working on or what you need to get done. To make the best out of your social media content calendar in Trello, we should do a board by social media. Let's start with Instagram. And so you can structure, it asks you to structure your wish list. So what we're gonna do is ideas of different posts you wanna create, to do, and ready to publish. And then into ideas, depends on what your Instagram is about, but on my Instagram, I would do Disney posts, personal posts. Inside that card that we just created, we can add a checklist, pictures, and we can add a description. So in Disney post, we're gonna do a checklist about every post that we are thinking of. So now we are going deep into it. So much more that we can do. Here we're gonna go on show menu and change the background right away. Planner, because this is a social media content calendar, right? And then here, if you don't like the way I did it, you can still archive this list or you can add another list. Let's do done, content, calendar. And so I will take this list and put it here. And then I'm going to do cards that are going to be divided by months. So we're still in July, so I'm going to add all the months until the end of the year. Those cards are going to be divided. To customize those cards, to make it a little bit more cool, I will add a cover. So when you click on that card, you can add a cover for this card. You can either use a color or you can add an image. You can also add one of your own cover. And so here is July and we're going to do the same for August. So here's your content calendar 2020 for your Instagram, the IDs, the to-do, the ready to publish, and done. Inside the cards, the content calendar 2020, we are going to add more cards. And inside those cards, we are going to add checklist and we are going to be able to move our cards into the different lists. So let me show you exactly what I'm talking about. Let's say I'm publishing one post a week. It's like four posts in July for each week. I'm gonna add a card. I'm going to post my Epcot picture. I'm going to put this card on July. And I also going to do personal post called wedding pic. That is my post, my four post for July in my content calendar. And so what I'm gonna do, when I have an idea of a post that I want to post during the month of August, I will go in here. I can add a cover. I could keep on adding. And once my idea are done, I just checked that is done. Now let's go back to our content calendar. So what we're going to do is that for the Epcot time, you can add a checklist like to do. And in this checklist, you're going to edit, pick, add a video, write caption, find hashtags, tag people. So this is what you have to do for this post. And let's say that you know what day performed the most for you. So let's say it's on Fridays and you know that's the best time to post. It's at 6 p.m. So you're going to do this and you're going to remind maybe 15 minutes before you post and save. You can also label this post. You can say it's complete. So your post is definitely complete. Or you can say in process, or it can be need caption. Let's say that you edit your picture and you add your videos, so this is not complete, but this is in the process and you need to write a caption, right? What I love to do is to copy this card and add it to your to-do. Now you know that in July you have those four posts that you want to make, and here will be what you are actually working on at the moment. So you can know what is complete, what is not, you have the due date, and once this is completely done, like you did everything on your checklist, so you don't need a caption anymore, this is complete, and you're going to change this to do and put it on ready to publish. So on July 31st, you will know that you need to publish your post, and once it's complete, you check and put it on done. And here you will have to do the same. You only have to write complete and it's due, and you have your content calendar for Instagram. So this is what I do for YouTube and for my blog posts the most. Now, when you go back on boards, you're gonna see your board. And you can create a new one from boards, and let's call it YouTube. Going to add whatever this, create a board, and we're going to do the same. So this is how it works from here. Make a board for everything you want. This is only a social media content calendar that I am showing you here, but you can absolutely create a board about your goals, grocery list, about whatever you feel like organizing and having on your computer. Good news is you can totally having Trello on your phone. If I don't have my computer, I have the app and I have all my boards, so I can keep track on what I'm doing when I have to do it. So this is very, very cool. And that's it, guys. I hope you love to know about Trello, what you can do with it. And if you want to know more, if you want more Trello's tutorial, please let me know in the comment down below. I will be happy to show you more things that you can do with Trello. Since I am teaching myself some new things, I will be very happy to share with you what I am discovering. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. Have a wonderful weekend. I will see you next Friday. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to never miss any video of mine. In the meantime, take care and see you next Friday. Bye.